Welcome back to our course on Project 2016. In this section we're going to look at the ribbon and toolbars. If you've used other Microsoft software that uses the ribbon and toolbars, it's probably the case that you can skip this section if you want to. I will talk about one or two things that are quite specific to Microsoft Project, but I think that if you're an experienced user of the ribbon, you'll be able to pick these up easily enough as we go along anyway. Now, for those of you who aren't so familiar with the ribbon, let me just explain. The ribbon system was introduced, well, about 8 or 9 years ago now, step by step through the various components of Microsoft Office, and it's now fairly fully and fairly consistently implemented in these components, including Project. As I pointed out already, it's this rectangle with a number of tabs, and you select a tab. So for instance, at the moment I have the report tab selected. You select a tab by clicking on the name. So this is the task tab, this is the resource tab, and so on. In Microsoft Project there's a whole batch of tabs: task, resource, report, project, that you will see whenever you're using Project. Now, this can be changed by local settings, but talking in general terms here. But there are some tabs that only appear in certain situations, and these are what's called contextual tabs. And we have a contextual tab here. It's this format tab, and the format tab in this case is part of what's called the Gantt chart tools. And this is contextual in that because we have a Gantt chart shown here, note the lying on its side label here, Gantt chart, we see the Gantt chart tools format tab, which enables us to format a Gantt chart to change the styling, etc. If I changed the view, so instead of showing the Gantt chart, I'm going to show, for example, a network diagram. I now have network diagram view, and I get a contextual tab for that, the format tab, which is part of the network diagram tools. We'll see some other contextual tabs as we go through the course, but let me for the moment go back into Gantt chart view. On each of the tabs, there are a number of controls. And the controls can be all sorts of things. They can be command buttons, they can be drop-down lists, they can be sets of radio buttons, etc. And they're arranged into groups. So for instance, on the View tab here, the group on the left is the Task Views group. And there are 5 controls here: Gantt chart, task usage, and these are the 3. Each of these controls can be a single control, or for instance, as in here, it can give access to a whole menu of other options. Now, I should point out here something that I did point out earlier on, and that is that depending on the size of your screen, depending on the resolution of your screen, depending on whether you're in mouse mode or touch mode, exactly what you see on each tab may well vary. You may see more or less controls in each of the groups than I do on this screen. I'm recording this course on a PC with quite a high resolution. If you have a smaller resolution PC, perhaps running it on a laptop with much less space on the screen, you may well see less than me. But you should pretty much see the same groups, even if exactly what you can see in each group is a little bit different from what I see. So let's now try to execute a command or two. I'm going to go to the Task tab. And one thing you'll notice is that some of the commands are greyed out. So for instance, in the Clipboard group on the Task tab, you have a Cut command, a Copy command, and something called a Format Painter that are not greyed out. So you could do those things at the moment. Whereas you can't use the Paste command, it's greyed out because we don't have anything copied to the clipboard. And as with Windows applications in general, of course, greying out indicates that a particular command is not available. Let me type a name of a task into this task name box for the first task in this little project. I could use the tick next to the entry bar or just press the Enter key. And I now have task 1. If I select that particular task name by clicking on the box, you can see that the box has a border around it, so it's selected. If I wanted to make that bold, I could use the bold command in the font group on the task tab. Text of that is now bold. I could make it italic, and I could change the font from Calibri to, say, Black Oak Standard, and I could make it a larger font size, for example. So that's basically how you can use the commands on the ribbon. Now, we're not restricted to styling text. If you take that particular task, you could do all sorts of things to it. For instance, you could record progress on that task using the commands on the ribbon, but more of that later. Now, slightly at the danger of getting ahead of ourselves here, one thing you'll notice, particularly as your projects get bigger, is that the ribbon does take up a lot of space, and particularly if you're using a small screen, it takes up a disproportionately large amount of space. You can hide the ribbon, and there's a little up arrow over here at the right hand end, says collapse the ribbon, and if you click on collapse the ribbon is hidden. Now you may say, well, that certainly gives me a bit more space, but how do I use the commands? The answer to that is that provided you've got a reasonable idea of where a command is, so for instance, if I wanted to change the size of that task one font back to 10 or 11 points, if I know the commands on the task tab, all I have to do is go back to the task tab, click on the name, and the ribbon reappears. So if I then say, OK, it's 18, I want to put it back to 11. And then if I want to execute another command, so for instance, I want to change the font. Once I've finished, click back in my project again, then the ribbon is hidden again. Now, when I described that to you, I said, if I know where the particular command is on the task tab in that case, if you don't know where it is, you can still click on any one of the tabs and you can click around until you find the particular command that you want. If you get to a point, though, at which you think, well, actually, I need the ribbon available all the time again, I don't want it collapsed anymore, if I just right-click in there again, notice collapse the ribbon is ticked. Just click to untick it, and the ribbon will be there all of the time now, and you can see all of the contents of the ribbon all of the time. One other thing I'd like to point out here is that you can customize the ribbon. And in particular, you can create your own ribbon tabs. And you may be wondering about these two tabs here, reporting and team. You may be looking at your installation or project and thinking, why haven't I got those? Well, these are two custom tabs that I have made for specific purposes. I'm not going to cover customization of the ribbon here, but I am going to briefly look at customizing the quick access toolbar a little bit later on in this section, and that should give you a pretty clear idea of how to set about customizing the ribbon. Let's now turn our attention to the quick access toolbar that we looked at earlier on in the course, and as you can see, mine has about 5 or 6 commands currently shown. One of them we talked about was the touch mouse mode command. And then we have undo and redo and save. You may be a little bit mystified by these two symbols here. These are two commands that I've put on the quick access toolbar. They're actually custom commands. I'll come back to those in just a moment. But as I explained earlier on, if you want to change what's shown on the quick access toolbar, there is a standard pool of commands. So if I wanted the quick print command shown, I'd select it from the menu here, click it, and quick print is now shown. Now, apart from switching on and off those standard commands, you can customize the quick access toolbar. And if I click on more commands here, it takes me into a page of the project options. Now, project options we're going to look at in 2 or 3 sections from now. But what we have open here is the quick access toolbar page, which we can use to customize the quick access toolbar. And let's suppose that I want to add a button to the toolbar, which will enable me with one click to make something bold. All I need to do is to find the bold command in the list on the left and then add it to the toolbar. Now, the list on the left is controlled by this drop down, and first of all we have the popular commands, and they're in alphabetical order. I can't see bold there, so if instead of popular commands I say all commands, I have access to the literally hundreds of commands that are available in Microsoft Project. And I want to find bold. There it is. So I select bold. I click on the add button be- between the two lists, and it's now added to my quick access toolbar. If I want to put it in a different position, I can select it and use the up and down arrows here to change its position in the list. And those two custom commands, I'm going to remove both of those. I don't need those at the moment, so I'm going to remove them. And that's it. I click on OK and my quick access toolbar will be customized. If at some stage you make a mistake and you want to go back to the default, the settings as they were originally, there's a reset button there. So click on OK. And there is my bold command on the quick access toolbar. And with the cell with the task name task 1 selected, I can switch bold on and off using that command. It may well be that after you've been using Project 2016 for a while, you will find it very useful to customize the quick access toolbar. Also, some people customize it to do particular jobs. So, for example, if a project manager is doing a weekly update of status, they may put various commands associated with task status on the quick access toolbar, or indeed create a custom tab for the ribbon for that purpose. One other thing about the quick access toolbar that some people find useful, it's right up in the top left hand corner there, and you have to sort of go across the ribbon to get to it. You can actually position it below the ribbon. It's very simple. Just click on the drop down there, show below the ribbon, and it appears down here. It's quite a bit easier to get to when you're doing perhaps a long or repetitive task within the body of a project. And then of course you do pretty much the opposite to put it back again. Now there's one other type of toolbar that I want to point out to you now, and it's one that pops up all over the place. We're going to be using this type of toolbar in many places in the course. If you take task 1 here, selected here, if I right click within that cell, I get what's called a contextual menu. And it's contextual in that the commands that are available there, although they're all also available from various places on the ribbon, these are deemed to be the ones that you're most likely to want to use in the situation that you're in. And above that contextual menu, there is a mini toolbar. And again, this is deemed to be contextual, to contain the commands that are appropriate to where you are in project and what you're doing. So these work pretty much on the principle I'm sure you'd expect them to. You click on things and they either execute commands or bring up other menus or bring up dialogues or whatever. So we have these contextual menus like this one, and then we have mini toolbars like this one. And as I say, we'll be using these at various points during the course. That's the end of this section. I'll see you in the next one.
Hi, I'm Molly. Thanks for watching. If you would like to see similar videos, click the subscribe button on the right. I'll see you next week with additional videos.